Hi, in this video, I'm going to give you an Adobe Lightroom quick tip. Hi, I'm Adam, and welcome to First Man Photography, the channel that will help you take your photography to the next level. If you haven't done so already, head over to firstmanphotography.com, fill in your details to join the email list, and I'll send you a free copy of the ebook on how to capture perfect exposure every time. Okay, let's get into this. On this channel before, I've talked about having a workflow that's non-destructive, and Adobe Lightroom provides that very well because you can make changes to your image and it won't affect the original image file. Sometimes though, you may want to have a different version of the same image. Like you might want to have a black and white version, a color version, or you may come back to that image a few weeks down the line and think, oh, I'd like to do something a little bit different with that, but you don't want to lose the original edit. Lightroom provides a nice, easy facility for us to create virtual copies of our pictures that we can then edit differently. So let's get into the computer and I'll show you very quickly how we can do that. Okay, so we go straight into Adobe Lightroom and this is the image I'm gonna be using. It's a picture of a sheep that I took recently. I've already used this image. I like it, I'm happy with the color, but I think I also want a black and white version because I think it's really gonna work well in black and white. So all you need to do is go to the grid here and right click, and then we go to create virtual copy. So just click that, it creates and it has this little thing here which sort of denotes that it's a copy, and then you can go ahead and edit that differently. So I'm just gonna open that up into the develop module and convert it to black and white. Now when I convert to black and white, I like to add more contrast on the tone curve as well here, and then increase the exposure a little bit. And I think, as you can see, that's a pretty good image in black and white, as well as the original color version. Now, another way that I use the virtual copy is I might want to edit it in a different way if I've come back to that image later and thought about it differently. So again, I do that. I will go right click and then go to create virtual copy. It does the same thing again, but this time I'll just go down to the develop settings and then just reset and you go back to the original raw file image. It's a nice little feature of Adobe Lightroom that I use very regularly and I find it really useful within my workflow. If you haven't got Adobe Lightroom yet, you can head down to the description below. I'll put a link there where it'll take you over to the Adobe website and you'll get a free trial. So that is the virtual copy feature of Adobe Lightroom. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that Adobe Lightroom quick tip. There'll be lots more coming, so please subscribe to the channel and I'll see you on another video very soon. I'm Adam, this is First Man Photography, out.